People often have diabetes for years without even knowing it. Diabetes can develop very slowly, especially type 2 diabetes, and the signs are easy to miss. So it's not rare for someone to get blood work and the blood sugar is sky high and they had no idea. One sign that someone might have hidden diabetes are slow healing cuts. Somebody notices a small nick from shaving, for example, and it takes many days or even weeks to heal. This happens because high blood sugar damages small blood vessels and also nerves. This reduces the blood flow to the wound, to the injured area, and so the delivery of nutrients and oxygen in the blood is reduced. High blood sugar can also weaken the immune system, which plays an important role in tissue repair. So if your paper cut lasts longer than a TikTok trend, it might be a good idea to get some blood work. We talked about damage to the immune system, and in fact, frequent infections are another sign of hidden diabetes. For example, someone starts going to their dentist several times a year with gum infections, just recurrent. This could be a sign of high blood sugar. Common infections seen in diabetics include UTIs, genital, skin in general, foot, and also oral. Gums or dental disease are common. Yeast infections also common, so oral thrush is an overgrowth of the yeast candida, which creates white patches on the tongue. Another common sign, in fact, this is one of the earliest signs of hidden diabetes, is needing to pee a lot, needing to pee all the time. So increased urination, why does that happen? Well, when you have very high blood sugar, some of that sugar, some of that glucose is going to be lost in the urine, and more sugar in the urine pulls water into it. That's called osmotic pressure. So that increases the volume of the urine, and so you need to pee more often. So somebody notices that they recently have to start getting up 3, 4, or 5 times a night to pee, and they think they're just getting older. If it's a man, could be prostate, but another possibility is high blood sugar. Also, if you're peeing a lot, you're going to be dehydrated, so you're going to be thirsty a lot. And it's another sign of hidden diabetes. Dry mouth, for the same reason, is also common. No need to freak out. This is about consistent patterns, not about a one-off, right? So if you're thirsty because you had some spicy food, that's completely normal. But if things changed and you started peeing a lot more or drinking a lot more water and you don't know why, might be worth looking into. This actually goes back to ancient Greece. Hippocrates, the father of medicine, would famously diagnose diabetes in his patients just on the back of these symptoms. If they suddenly needed to pee a lot and were thirsty all the time. And another thing he reported was that these patients that had diabetes, their urine became very sweet. That's right, he was tasting the urine of his patients. Now, that's devotion to medicine. Modern doctors complaining about work hours. You got it pretty good, man. You can just send the urine to the lab. This guy was actually tasting all that bladder cocktail. Did you hear the one about the doctor who drank a lot of urine? Yeah, apparently he got piss drunk. In fact, the very name of the disease, the full name is diabetes mellitus. Mellitus comes from the Latin word that means honey or honey-like, precisely because the urine would become sweet like honey. Another common sign of hidden diabetes is blurry vision. High blood sugar can affect the fluid balance in the lens of the eye, so that can cause temporary blurry vision. But sustained very high blood sugar over time can also damage blood vessels and nerves, as we said, so that can cause damage to the retina, the back of the eye. This is called diabetic retinopathy or disease of the retina. So the blood vessels in the retina become damaged, and this can cause permanently blurry vision. And if it's not addressed, it can progress to other serious issues, including blindness. So sometimes people notice their vision is blurry, they start getting new glasses, but their vision is changing every week. It might not be the glasses, it might be your blood sugar. Another common sign is unexplained fatigue. Difference between tiredness and fatigue. When you're tired, you get some rest and you feel better. But if you have persistent fatigue, even after resting, maybe you just woke up and you had a full night's sleep, and you're still feeling exhausted and even lethargic. One reason this happens in diabetics is all that blood sugar, all that glucose stays in the blood, doesn't go into the cells where it's supposed to go to be used for energy. So you feel drained even though you slept really well because you're lacking energy. Hypoglycemia, low blood sugar, which can happen in diabetics, especially as a result of medication, sometimes taking too much insulin or a high dose of anti-diabetic medication. Hypoglycemia can also cause fatigue. Another sign is constant hunger, even after eating. You just had food shortly after, you're hungry again. This is called polyphagia, or eating a lot is what the word means. And this happens because your body is not using sugar normally. It's leaving all that sugar in circulation. It can't use it effectively for energy. So your body feels like it's starving, even though there's plenty of energy floating around in your blood and you just ate. And hypoglycemia, those valleys of low glucose, can also cause hunger. Another common sign, you've probably heard of this one, is tingling or numbness on the tips of your fingers or on your toes. This is often referred to as a pins and needles sensation. Sensations of burning or pain can also be reported. And this happens because high blood sugar over long periods of time can cause nerve damage. Skin changes is another common one. Skin darkening, for example, something called acanthosis nigricans. It's a patch of dark velvety skin, especially seen in skin folds like the armpits or the neck or the groin. And it's a classic sign of insulin resistance. This happens because very high levels of insulin sustained over a long period of time stimulates cells to divide, to reproduce, and so the skin can become thicker and darker. So if you've got a dark patch of skin showed up out of nowhere, doesn't go away with scrubbing, problem might not be the soap. It might be your insulin and glucose metabolism. Other signs that may also happen include itchy skin or dry skin, also from the dehydration, because you're peeing a lot, so you're dehydrated, and also the poor circulation. Both can cause this. Your mood can be affected, so mood swings, irritability. This happens because of the glucose changes, the sugar highs, and the crashes. High blood sugar, what's called hyperglycemia, can cause tiredness, difficulty concentrating, and the crash is the hypoglycemia, the low blood sugar, often from high doses of meds or injecting insulin, can cause agitation or nervousness. Another sign is ED, erectile dysfunction, or impotence. And this happens because of the damage to the blood vessels and the nerves that affects the physiological process of erection. And finally, unexplained, unintentional weight loss. So you start losing weight, you don't know why, you didn't change anything in particular. This is more common in type 1 diabetes, but can also happen in type 2. This can be a result of the sugar that you're losing in your urine. And also, like we said, all that blood sugar in circulation, not going into the cells, the body kind of feels like it's starving. And so it starts to burn fat and also muscle for energy, and that can cause weight loss. If you notice any of these signs, two things you can do right away. First, test. Get a fasting blood sugar reading, a fasting glucose, or a glycated hemoglobin, a hemoglobin A1C. And number two, lifestyle changes. We now understand that both prediabetes and diabetes, type 2 diabetes, are quite reversible with healthy lifestyle, diet and exercise primarily. And we covered exactly how to do that in this previous video. So check it out, and I'll see you in there.